Hi, this video provides a quick overview of concept map as a mind tool for critical thinking. So first, let's go to this website to complete a simple exercise. In this website, you will learn the basic concept of mind mapping. First, choose your own representation, and then let's do a simple exercise on what do you prefer to eat? And what do you prefer to drink? So this one, we can help learner to map out some ideas about themselves and their preferences. And when do they like to eat? And what kind of food do they prefer? And the temperature and the amount of drink. So this is a process to help learner plan their thinking and then use a visual format to present their idea. So what exactly is mind tool? According to Hornison, mind tools are computer-based tools and learning environment that has been adapted or developed to function as intellectual partners with the learners in order to engage and facilitate critical thinking and higher order thinking. Therefore, concept map tools can be used as a mind tool to enhance learner understanding and their metacognitive skills. And what are the psychological reasons for using mind map? There are, according to Novak and Karnas, there are three main reasons. It helps learners relate materials to prior knowledge. It helps them to build conceptual framework, and learners can incorporate new meaning into their prior knowledge through the construction of concept maps. Another way to look at reasons why we need to use mind map is in the traditional rote learning, there's no or little relevant knowledge for learners. There's no emotional commitment to new or existing knowledge. Whereas if we can engage learners in meaningful learning, they will require well-organized relevant knowledge structures and it will provide emotional commitment to integrate new information with existing knowledge. Therefore, it may lead to creative production and acquisition of new knowledge. And in this road to meaningful learning continuum, you can see using autonomous discovery instruction to guide learners will help to achieve better learning. And there are different techniques to provide instruction. For example, we can either provide a multiplication table that learner can memorize and hopefully they can apply that to the actual calculation, or they can use a concept map to present their understandings that therefore it will provide a more meaningful learning activities. And another way to look at how this will affect our memory system, using concept map, it activates all parts of the memory functions. It activates short-term memory, and through the concept maps or mind tools, information can process into working memories and will be saved into long-term memories. It's affective because there are emotional engagement with the material the learners are learning. It utilizes motor skills because learners need to construct their own mental mind map. According to a classic study by Shepard in 1967, in this study they showed subjects 612 pictures and they found the subjects are very good at remembering, retaining the information right after the post-test, and or they can retain 92% of the information after 3 days when they were called back to test mixture all the new information. They were able to recall information they have learned 3 days ago. And when they were called back 3 months later, they can still retain 58% of the information. Whereas if you use only words or audio clips, the percentage wasn't that high. All these lead to the use of concept map are beneficial to reinforce learning or engage learners. There are different types of concept maps you can create, or we can engage learners in creating. They can be used to brainstorm, generate ideas, or to show different categories of information, or to show diagram, or to show a planning of activities. Learners can also use it to visually analyze, criticize, and advocate ideas. They can use it to map out relationship between ideas. They can use it to organize thought. And it can be used to provide outline of information. These are a few examples of brainstorming, using it to provide a web of information, or use it to, as a comparison diagram. It can be used to plan the content they are learning, or present critical thinking. It can be used to map out ideas, or to show organizations of, in this case, a dynasty in China. It can use to compare the outlines of characters. And here are a few tools that can be useful for you to try out. Puppet, Goggle It, Mind Up. These are all tools that can be used on both iPads, tablets, and computers. So here's a few examples of the visual presentations of these tools. Puppet is a graphic organizer that you can incorporate images with text and make all connection in many ways. Cargoid is usually used to present a map of information, a roadmap of concepts. And mind map, you can use it to create different bubbles and show connections or incorporate images. And mind map, as well as Cargoid, allow people to collaborate. So students can work in teams to collaborate on the same concept map from different devices as long as they share the graphic with each other. Here's another free tool called Gliffy, which comes with a lot of templates that you can use to modify or start from scratch. Here are a few more examples. So now give it a try and see which one fits for your purpose and your target learners better. Have fun!